American Brooks Koepka hits from a deep bunker near the 18th green during a practice round Wednesday at Royal St. George's Golf Course, where the British Open begins today. AP, Peter Morrison, Sandwich, England, Danny Willett shrugged his shoulders, grabbed his tee and returned to his caddie beside the fourth tee at Royal St. George's. He just hit what he thought was the ideal drive during his final practice round at the British Open, only for one of the bumps on the course's lunar-like landscape to throw it offline and into the rough. "Kicked left," Willett said, before smiling. "Never asked for it. Expect the unexpected" will be the motto for the world's best golfers this week as they get a crack at links golf for the first time in 2 years in this picturesque corner of southeast England. In some respects, this British Open will feel as though golf has returned to normal. There will be some 30,000 fans roaming the Sandwich links daily today through Sunday, the biggest golf crowd at a major since the pandemic. Those oohs and aahs and rumbling roars from a distance are all part of Open lore, and they'll return. Golf missed them last year when its oldest championship was cancelled for the first time since 1945 because of the coronavirus outbreak. Big-time sporting events need big-time crowds, R&A Chief Executive Martin Slumbers said. Then again, this week couldn't be more different. Players are being kept in a strict bubble to comply with COVID-19 restrictions devised by the R&A and are at risk of disqualification for breaching rules. "It's probably inevitable that we will have some problems," said Slumbers, who has already seen Masters champion Hideki Matsuyama and Zach Johnson, the 2015 British Open champion, withdraw after testing positive for the virus, and Bubba Watson forced to pull out for being a close contact of a positive case. During a practice round Monday, Phil Mickelson appeared concerned he was getting too close to spectators. "He was like, 'Can you just give me some space? I don't know who you are,'" said English qualifier Nick Poppleton, who played alongside Mickelson. On Wednesday, a spectator threw a ball to Mickelson for him to sign. The PGA champion immediately threw it back, without signing it, and wiped his hands with a towel. And then there's the course at Royal St. George's, disrespected by some and unloved by many more for being unfair. Balls can be propelled almost sideways by the undulations on the fairways, some of which can be unhittable, especially in dry and fast conditions. The fairways on the first and 17th holes promise to be particularly tough, not to mention the one on the fourth, as Willett can attest. "It's not my favorite of the open rotation," Brooks Koepka said of a course once described to American golfer Charles Howell III as the world's largest pinball machine. Helping the players this week is the rain that has lashed down on the course, which has made it green and soft.